गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ सरस्वती विद्या मंदिर कॉमर्स सेक्शन इन इकोनॉमिक्स इन प्रीवियस चैप्टर दिस चैप्टर द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर चैप्टर फोर प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डिफिशियंट एंड एक्सेस डिमांड एंड इट्स कॉरेक्टिव मेजर्स वर रिलेटेड विद द चैप्टर प्रीवियस चैप्टर इनकम डिटर्मिनेशन इनकम एंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट डिटर्मिनेशन इन एन इकोनॉमी स्टूडेंट्स In that chapter, we see that when AD and AS, aggregate demand and aggregate supply, became equal to each other, that is known as equilibrium situation. And whether the aggregate demand and aggregate supply intersect each other, at that point, the equilibrium level of income and employment were decided. But whenever there is disequilibrium between these two variables, aggregate demand and aggregate supply, in that situation economies suffer from either inflationary situation or deflationary situation and both situation were more critical for economy thus every economy will try to prevent their own economy from that type of situation and for this they always try to from its monetary and fiscal policy they try to remain the economy in equilibrium situation This is the sub part of this chapter, chapter 4, problem of deficient and excess demand and its corrective measures. But after the whole analysis of the chapter, aggregate demand and aggregate supply, we see that in classical economics, as they very easily they find equilibrium between AD and AS, but their concept were based upon ex ante approach and due to this the 1929 Great Depression appeared in front of US United States of America and at that time Keynes came and Keynes state again that ex ante and ex the difference between ex ante post concept and ex post concept and they state that only realized or actual demand level can able to decide the employment and income level in an economy and thus it is very necessary that aggregate effective demand become equal to aggregate effective supply it means that they state that in an economy for equilibrium it is very necessary that aggregate effective demand should be yani ex post demand should be equal to ex post supply aggregate supply ex post aggregate supply should be equal to ex post aggregate demand and that equilibrium only can be sustained for long time period and that equilibrium can only provide full employment equilibrium in an economy deficient demand agar us aggregate effective demand jo chahiye pun rozgar ke star ke liye अगर उससे हमारा डिमांड कम है तो दैट इज नोन एज डेफिशिएंट डिमांड मांग में कमी उस कमी को बताती है जो पूर्ण रोजगार के लिए आवश्यक है पूर्ण रोजगार के स्तर के लिए जो मांग का स्तर चाहिए अगर उस स्तर से डिमांड कम है तो दैट लेवल ऑफ डिमांड वो जो कमी है deficient demand it refers to the situation when aggregate demand AD is short of aggregate supply AS corresponding to full employment in the economy yani economy mein rozgar ke liye jo level chahiye aggregate effective demand barabar aggregate effective supply aur ye level se jo aggregate demand kam hai isko hum deficient demand kehte hain yani deficient in other words we can say In this situation, aggregate demand in the economy is less than what is required to maintain full employment. Supply है, लेकिन aggregate demand का level हमको उस aggregate effective supply के क्योंकि aggregate effective supply is always a post concept. And there were no matter with supply, there is matter with demand. यानि it means that demand should be going to be match with supply. Supply is available. Supply is already supplied. Supply is already produced amount, which is supplied in market and willing to sell by every producer. But the now important question is, is demand level is that level which is going to be matched with this supply level? If demand level also became equal to the level of that supply, then economy can be remain in full employment situation. And if the demand is getting shortfall from that supply level, in that situation, that economy suffer from deficient demand, or that is known as deflationary situation, जिसको हम मंदी कहते हैं, यानी मांग का कम होना. इन दिस सिचुएशन एग्रीगेट डिमांड इन द इकोनॉमी इज लेस देन व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू मेंटेन फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट, दस इट लीड्स टू फॉल इन जनरल प्राइस लेवल एंड रिजल्ट इन डिफ्लेशन. और इसके कारण क्या होता है, जब मांग कम होगा सप्लाई के लेवल से, जो रिक्वायर्ड डिमांड चाहिए ताकि फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट हो, एग्रीगेट डिमांड शुड एग्रीगेट इफेक्टिव डिमांड शुड बी एग्री इक्वल टू एग्रीगेट इफेक्टिव सप्लाई. एंड इफ देयर इज एग्रीगेट डिमांड गेट शॉर्ट ऑफ देन द एग्रीगेट सप्लाई, देन द गैप विल बी अराइज गैप, एंड दैट गैप वर नोन एज डिफ्लेशनरी गैप. डिफ्लेशनरी गैप द एक्सटेंट ऑफ विच करेंट एग्रीगेट डिमांड फॉल शॉर्ट ऑफ द एक्चुअल एग्रीगेट डिमांड रिक्वायर्ड फॉर फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट is termed as deflationary gap. What is deflationary gap? Deflationary gap refers that gap which is get in existence due to sort of current aggregate demand which is actually required for full employment from the aggregate effective supply level, and that is deflationary gap. And that gap is should be fulfilled by government by their own expenditure on public facilities as it is stated by Keynes. Once again, we can understand this whole topic, deficient demand or deflationary gap, from this given figure diagram, as we know that aggregate supply line or income line, which is a 45 degree line, and that is aggregate demand, the previous aggregate demand, AD1. ये इसको हम AD1 को हम क्लासिकल डिमांड भी कहते हैं, क्लासिकल एग्रीगेट डिमांड. और यहीं पर क्लासिकल इकोनॉमिक्स क्लासिकल अर्थशास्त्रियों ने पूर्ण रोजगार को मान लिया था. वेदर द सिंपल AD एंड AS गेट इंटरसेक्ट ईच अदर एंड दैट एट दैट पॉइंट दे एज्यूम फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट बिकॉज दे होल रन ऑन द एक्स एंटे कॉन्सेप्ट एंड दे नेवर रियलाइज दैट that demand level were not going to be equally matched with aggregate supply, and there is a gap or arise between AD and AS, and that is resultant in Great Depression of 1929. And thus and that AD when AD and what is the full employment equilibrium aggregate demand, full employment equilibrium aggregate effective demand, that is ADF, whether at full employment equilibrium. When ADF When we increase the demand level from AD to ADF, AD1 to ADF, that is, जब हम इस डिमांड लेवल को एग्रीगेट इफेक्टिव डिमांड को जब हम बढ़ाते हैं ADF फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट लेवल में, देन इट एक्चुअली मैच विथ द एग्रीगेट इफेक्टिव सप्लाई लेवल. हियर ऑन ई पॉइंट एग्रीगेट इफेक्टिव सप्लाई बिकेम इक्वल टू एग्रीगेट इफेक्टिव डिमांड. And that is full employment, actual full employment level. But the gap which is remain between ADF and AD1, that is inflationary gap, that is deflationary gap. It means कि इतने मांग की न्यूनता है जितना मांग होना चाहिए पूर्ण रोजगार के लिए E1 पर, और वर्तमान मांग है E पर, तो ये जो गैप है आपको, इतने मांग की कमी है. और इसी मांग को केन्स के शब्दों में ये कौन पूरा करेगा, दैट इज ब्रिज अप बाय गवर्नमेंट एक्सपेंडिचर. इफ ए गवर्नमेंट बिलीव इन वेलफेयर इकोनॉमी, देन दैट गवर्नमेंट मस्ट बी इंटरफेयर इन टू इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज एंड मस्ट बी ब्रिज अप द गैप बिटवीन एक्चुअल एग्रीगेट सप्लाई एंड एक्चुअल एग्रीगेट डिमांड टू रिमेन द इकोनॉमी इन फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट इक्विलिब्रियम सिचुएशन. एंड here the government should be match that bridge up that gap with their own expenditure, and then in economy became in full employment situation, and before and the level of aggregate demand which is falls short from the demand level, aggregate demand level which is needed for full employment level, that gap is deflationary gap. So now it is clear that what is deflationary gap. Deflationary gap is the extent, is the gap which is it is the gap between aggregate demands. The deflationary gap is actually a gap between aggregate demands. It is the gap between that aggregate demand which is actual and that aggregate demand which is needed for full employment level. तो हम ये भी कह सकते हैं कि aggregate demand और aggregate effective demand के बीच जो gap है इसको हम लोग deflationary gap कहते हैं. Deflationary gap is a gap between the level of actual aggregate demand and the level of aggregate effective demand which is needed to maintain the full employment equilibrium situation. That is deflationary gap. And when there is deflationary gap or deflationary situation prevail in any economy, at that situation the general price level was going to be down. There were no motive to further investment. There were decrease in employment and income level, and slightly economy were get globs of deflation or depreciation. हम कहते हैं जो मंदी है depression में वो economy slightly चला जाएगा. So there is need to be further investment to revive economy, to boost up economy, to accelerate economy once again. जैसा कि अभी कोरोना के समय में नरेंद्र मोदी ने 20 लाख करोड़ रुपया देकर 20 लाख करोड़ रुपया जो है वो यही गवर्नमेंट एक्सपेंडिचर है विच इज नीडेड और मेड बाय नरेंद्र मोदी टू बूस्ट अप द इकोनॉमी, टू एक्सलरेट द इकोनॉमी, टू ब्रिज अप द गैप बिटवीन एक्चुअल एग्रीगेट डिमांड एंड द एग्रीगेट डिमांड लेवल विच इज नीडेड फॉर फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट सिचुएशन. तो दैट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डिफिशियंट डिमांड. आई होप दैट यू ऑल अंडरस्टैंड. मस्ट मेक योर ओन नोट्स इन योर होमवर्क नोटबुक. And also remember the concept and clear the concept. If any question must be asked, stay home, safe home. Till then, okay, bye.